Srimati Indira Nehru Gandhi versus Sri Raj Narain and another. This was a case which was decided by Supreme Court of India with the bench consisting of Justice A. N. Ray, Justice HR Khanna, Justice K. K. Mathew, Justice M. Hamidullah Beg, and Justice YV Chandrachud. This case was decided on 7th of November 1975. In this case, appeal was filed by Srimati Indira Nehru Gandhi against the judgment of the Allahabad High Court, whereby election petition filed by Sri Raj Narain to question the election of the appellant to the Lok Sabha from Rai Bareilly parliamentary constituency was allowed and the election of the appellant was declared void. Appellant Indira Nehru Gandhi was found guilty of having committed corrupt practices under Section 123, Subsection 7 of the Representation of the People Act 1951, and as such was stated to be disqualified for a period of 6 years in accordance with Section 8A of the RP Act. During the pendency of the appeals, the Parliament passed the Election Laws Amendment Act 1975. On 6th of August 1975, by which certain amendments were made in the provisions of the Representation of the People Act 1951 and the Indian Penal Code. On 10th of August 1975, the Parliament, in the exercise of its constituent powers, passed the Constitution 39th Amendment Act 1975, hereinafter referred to as the Amendment. The Constitution 39th Amendment Act 1975 contains three principal features. Number 1, Article 71 has been substituted by a new Article 71. The new Article 71 states that subject to the provisions of the Constitution, Parliament may by law regulate any matter relating to or connected with the election of a President or Vice President, including the grounds on which such election may be questioned. The second feature was insertion of Article 329A in the Constitution. Clause 4 of the Article 329A was challenged in the appeals. The first clause states that subject to the provisions of Chapter 2 of the Part 5, except subclause E of the Clause 1 of Article 102, no election to either House of Parliament of a person who holds the office of Prime Minister at the time of such election or is appointed as Prime Minister after such election, and to the House of the People of a person who holds the office of Speaker of that House at the time of such election, or who is chosen as the Speaker for the House after such election, shall be called in question except before such authority, not being any such authority as is referred in Clause B of Article 329, or body and in such manner as may be provided for by or under any law made by Parliament, and any such law may provide for all other matters relating to doubts and disputes in relation to such election, including the grounds on which such election may be questioned. Under the second clause, the validity of any such law, as is referred to in clause 1, and the decision of any authority or body under such law shall not be called in question in any court. And the third clause states that where any person is appointed as Prime Minister or as the case may be chosen to the office of the Speaker of the House of the People, while an election petition referred to in Article 329 be in respect of his election to either House of Parliament or as the case may be to the House of the People is pending, such election petition shall abate upon such person being appointed as Prime Minister or as the case may be being chosen as the office of the Speaker of the House of the People. But such election may be called in question under any such laws as is referred in Clause 1. The fourth clause, which directly concerns the present appeal, states that no law made by Parliament before the commencement of the Constitution 39th Amendment Act 1975, insofar as it relates to election petitions and matters connected therewith, shall apply or shall be deemed ever to have applied to or in relation to the election of any such person as is referred to in Clause 1 to either House of Parliament, and such election shall not be deemed to be void or ever to have become void on any ground on which such election could be declared to be void under any such law or notwithstanding any other made by any court. before such commencement, declaring such election to be void, such election shall continue to be valid in all respects, and may such order and any finding on which such order is based shall be and shall be deemed always to have been void and of no effect. The fifth clause states that any appeal or cross appeal against any such order of any court as is referred to in clause 4 pending immediately before this commencement of the Constitution 39th Amendment Act 1975 before the Supreme Court shall be disposed of in conformity with the provisions of clause 4. The sixth clause states that the provisions of this article shall have effect notwithstanding anything contained in the Constitution. Supreme Court in this case held that under guise of exercising legislative power, Parliament cannot adjudicate on merits of election dispute. Therefore, court held that Article 329A, Clause 4 inserted by 39th Constitutional Amendment Act struck down as it violated the basic structure of the Constitution.